The overall goal of the following experiment is to determine if the insect has developed resistance to the insecticide. This is achieved by making concentrations to be tested by dissolving technical-grade insecticide into acetone for contact insecticides, as described by Plapidol in 1987, or honey water solution for systemic insecticides, as described by Snodgrass et al. In 2008. As a second step, aliquot 0.5 milliliters of the acetone insecticide solution into a 20 milliliter glass scintillation vial and rotate vials on a commercial hot dog roller with the heating element turned off, or aliquot 0.5 milliliters of the honey water insecticide solution onto a piece of floral foam placed inside a vial. Next, collect the desired insect for the adult vial test in order to conduct the bioassay, which monitors for insecticide resistance. Results are obtained that show whether or not the insect has developed resistance to the insecticide based on comparing the LC50 achieved via probit analysis to pre-existing LC50s.
Hello, my name is Audra Miller. I'm from the University of Missouri College of Agriculture, Food, and Natural Resources Delta Research Center in Portageville, Missouri. I will be conducting an experiment out of Dr. Kelly Tindall's entomology lab. I will be showing the procedure to detect whether or not insecticide resistance is occurring. Now let's get started.
It is imperative to use proper safety precautions, like safety goggles, masks, and gloves, etc., when handling insecticides. Consult the material safety data sheet for the recommended personal protective equipment of the specific pesticide being tested. In order to make a stock solution, adjust for purity, and measure technical-grade insecticide in a weighboat. In the hood, partially fill a volumetric flask with acetone. Add the insect.